here in Costa Ballena Golf Club. Here we are again with another video to help you with your game. Last time we did a video on aiming, the importance of aiming. Today we're gonna have another video with a very different subject. Today we're seeing low point control, and you will tell me, Enrique, what are you talking about? Well, we are talking about the pureness of the strike. We are talking about hitting the ball in the middle. So what do we need? Any golfer, Tiger Woods, Enrique, myself, Jesus here in the camera, what do we need to hit the ball perfectly? We need to hit the ball first. If we hit, obviously, the ground, we are going to lose all that energy. Well, it's not lost, but it's transferred to the ground, and the ball doesn't receive any, which is what we want. So what are we going to do? First of all, understand this. If we want to hit the ball first, the club head needs to reach the ball downwards. We call that angle of attack, and the angle of attack in golf needs to be negative. If the angle of attack is positive, what is going to happen? As we said, the club has to come from a lower point. So the club head is going to strike here in the ground and then the ball. Then several things can happen. Obviously, all that energy is transferring to the ground and not the ball, and we're going to top it probably, or even hit it very poorly at the end. So anytime you are hitting the ground before the ball, think about this. We need to actually hit the ball and then the grass. So what do we call low point, where we started today, is the area of the grass that we hit, the lowest point of the ball, of the golf swing. Any good player has the lowest point after the ball, not before. And sometimes, most of amateurs have the lowest point around here. So that means that sometimes they hit it fat, sometimes they hit it just here, but never here. And we have to talk another thing, loft, because as you saw before, if I'm hitting the ball downwards with the club head here, what's happening is that we are de-lofting the club. This is a 7-iron that has 33 degrees of loft here. This angle here is 33 degrees. If we hit it downwards, that 33 is gonna probably transform into 25, 23 degrees. That means distance too. So why we are here in our performance golf lab today? Because we're gonna have the help of Trackman. Trackman is a Doppler radar that has a technology that was used before as a military weapon. It used to measure the trajectory of missiles. So right now, obviously, it's not for that, it's for golf balls, but it's similar. So what are we gonna see today? First of all, I'm gonna hit a ball, and I'm gonna show you what the low point is with help of Trackman. So my colleague Jesus is gonna stand there for a second, and I'm gonna try to hit a ball that is very typical of amateurs. The lowest point is gonna be before the ball. It looks something like this, and some of you are gonna see this like something familiar. I'm gonna hit the grass just a tiny bit, and I'm gonna scoop up the ball up into there. So let's go. If that movement seems similar to you, it's probably because we are hitting the lowest point very close to the ball. For example, in this case, my lowest point was 3.6 centimeters just after the ball. If that A was a B, that would meant that it was ground and then ball. But I didn't hit that one fat, so that's the reason why it was after. As you can see, the attack angle is very shallow. That means that zero would be completely shallow, plus one would be going up into the air, and minus one is very close to zero. So what are we going to do? We're gonna try to put that low point, instead of 3.6, we're gonna go and try to put it even forward. So that would be around 7 centimeters past after the ball. And as you can see, the angle of attack is gonna be lower. It's gonna be minus three, minus four. So, and as a consequence, the carry distance is gonna improve severely, and the total distance too. So let's go for it. What are we going to do to improve that? Obviously, I'm not gonna hit the ball and have both feet in the ground. What I'm gonna try to do is transfer my weight from my right side to my front side, which is the left one, as a right-handed player. So, let's go. We're gonna try to move forward, and as a consequence, the lowest point is gonna be around here. Let's go. And as you can see, we managed to do both. Now, angle of attack, instead of minus one, it went minus four, which is good. Lowest point is not 3 centimeters after the ball, is 9. And the carry distance, because I went a little bit faster, obviously, it went farther. it was a 7-iron. So what are we gonna take as a consequence about this? If you are struggling with fat shots, that means that basically you have to understand the concept of low point and understand that we are not gonna try to hit the ball and scoop up into the air. We are gonna actually smash it into the ground, and probably we have to look to put that lower point much farther, much closer to what would be your left side as a right-handed player. So, hope that helped. Remember to visit us here in the magnificent province of Cádiz. We're here with 364 days of sun every year, as we said the last time. No, you never know what's gonna happen in the last one. And I hope to see you next month with another instructional video. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe to our golf channel, and hope to see you soon. Bye-bye.